When preparing to perform a new machining operation, there are two activities that the operator normally has to do: creating the work zero offset of the workpiece, and creating, resetting, and more generally managing the tools. Today, Paolo, it is precisely this last aspect that we will start from, so let's not waste any more time. I am Paraday, he is Paolo, and this is CNC, of course. One of the main operational activities to be executed on board the machine concerns the tools. While the program can be done off-machine in all possible ways, such as the use of various editors, CAD/CAM, and programming stations, the tools in Work Zero Offset are instead activities to be executed on the machine, at least in the most normal working conditions. In fact, in the part of the course dealing with advanced Siemens programming, we will see how to load tools from the program, but this is a very special and highly automated case. Let's see what an operator has to do to manage tools before starting a machining operation. The sequence will be roughly as follows. Create and configure the tools in the tool list if they do not already exist. Set the tool in order to define the tool length and, if necessary, the tool radius to be entered in the tool list, so that the numerical control knows the dimensions to activate the correct length and radius compensations. Before we start with the actual operator activities, let's try to understand more generally how tools are managed on the Siemens 840D. First of all, we will see where to find all the information relating to tools and the main functions concerning the tool list. All tool information can be found by clicking the Offset soft key, or by pressing Menu Select and then the Parameters soft key. Now that we are in the Parameters menu, we will have three standard soft keys relating to tools. The first soft key, as the name suggests, will show us the list of all tools with all the various parameters, regardless of whether the tool is loaded into the machine magazine or not. The second soft key shows us the previous list, but only with the fields dedicated to wear management. Yes, Paolo, because the tool consumes as it works. And if necessary, we can keep the wear-related tool corrections separate from the initial reset values. This is exactly what the tool wear page is for. The third standard Siemens soft key is the tool magazine button. This page is used to manage the tool magazine, and therefore all information relating to tool management within the magazine. In addition to these three standard Siemens menus, it may happen that some builders create their own tool management page with customized information, and usually insert the soft key in the blank space between tool wear and tool magazine. Now let's look at the tool list, which is also the most important page for tool management. The tools list is the page in which most of the operations regarding tools are carried out. It is in this page that we create a new tool, that we look for it, and that we update its main technical information. The list shows all the tools, even if they are not in the tool magazine. In the first column on the right, there is the number indicating where it is located on the tool magazine. For example, number 1 means place number 1 in the tools magazine, number 2 corresponds to place number 2 in the tool magazine, etc. Therefore, the tool next to number 1 will be the one located in the first position in the tool magazine. In this case, in the first position of the tools chain, there is the tool Cutter 4. So, scrolling down the tools list, we can see that the magazine has 40 pockets. All those under 40 are the tools not located in the tool magazine. They are therefore configurated tools, which even may be set and ready to be loaded in the tool magazine or to be used in a manual tool change. Going back to the first line of the list, we can find the symbol of the spindle. In fact, we can find here the tool that is actually located in the machine. Let's go in the machine screen and control the state window. We can see that in the nose spindle, the tool pre-drill 30 is loaded. We can see the same list in the case of a lathe with a 12-position turret. Also in this case, the first column represents the turret pocket number. Now let's go back to the milling tool list and proceed to see the other fields that make up the tool list. The second column shows a graphic symbol that identifies the tool type. We will see that as soon as we create a new tool, the first information to be entered is the tool type. There are basically two reasons why it's useful to enter the type correctly. The first one is that we can sort the tools by type. To do this, simply use the vertical soft keys to click on the Sort button, and then select By Type. In this way, we have sorted the tools by type, as if we were grouping all tools of the same type. To return to the Sorting by Magazine location, select the soft key By Magazine. The second reason for indicating the tool type relates to the specific geometrical data by type. Each tool will certainly have technical characteristics typical of milling tools and turning tools, which will always be required for each tool, to which are added specific features per tool type. Let's start with milling tools. The two fundamental technical data that are present for all tools are length and diameter. The length is the distance from the spindle nose to the tool tip, or better, to the part of the tool that we want to move using our program. The diameter will only be considered when using the tool radius compensation functions G41 and G42 in ISO programming, or when using the milling or profile milling cycles. Before continuing, I would just like to point out that the machine builder may configure the table with the tool radius instead of the diameter. So pay close attention to whether your machine has the diameter symbol or the letter R for the radius. Now let's look at the turning tools. The essential basic parameters are length X and length Z, which are used to tell the numerical control where the tooltip is located, and therefore the point we wish to move using our program. In addition to the two dimensions X and Z of the tool, the radius of the tooltip is also added. In this case, as with the radius of the milling cutter, it will be used by the control when we use functions G41 or G42 in our ISO turning programs, or when we use the Siemens canned cycles for turning operations. Given the basic parameters that are always present for both milling and turning, let's see what we meant when we said that there are specific parameters linked to the type of tool. Let's start from the turning tools, and we can see that in the tools list, after the radius column, there are other data. All the other columns will change their meaning based on the type of tool. For example, if we have chosen a roughing tool, we will be asked for the nose angle, the tool cutting edge angle, and the length of the cutting edge. But not only that, the most interesting thing is that by selecting one family rather than another, Siemens fills in the fields for us with default values. It is the same thing for milling. In this case, we see that the first two fields are also dedicated to the length and diameter, and that we have two other columns after the diameter that will change meaning based on the type. We can see that if we put the cursor on the column following the diameter and move downwards, passing from one type of tool to another, the description of the column itself changes. For milling cutters, we see that the field is deactivated, while if we move to the center drill D.12, the definition of the field that represents the point angle appears, which usually for center drills is 90 degrees, and is also the default value that Siemens sets for this type of drill. If I move down and go to a drill, for example to the MDI drill D.8.5, the column also represents the point angle, which by default Siemens sets at 118 degrees. For carbide and steel drills, it's usually more like 130 degrees, but at least Siemens sets a fairly correct close value. It's up to the user to modify it to suit their own tools. Moving down, we find a tap M10, and in this case, the pitch is requested. Let's move down to where we find a disc milling cutter D.125 5 millimeters thick. And we see that the column will request the thickness of the cutter. Going back up, we move on to the next column. This column is for indicating the number of cutting edges on the cutter. In fact, for drills, the field is deactivated, whereas for cutters, we will indicate the number of cutting edges. Good point, Paolo. Let me try to explain. As long as the programming is done in a fully ISO language and without using Siemens cycles, the only information needed is the following. For milling, the length and the radius. For turning, the length in X and length in Z. The radius in the tooltip orientation if radius compensation is used. Paolo, of course nothing gets past you. Sometimes you have a bad temper, but in the end, you always ask me useful questions. Unfortunately, you'll have to wait for the next lesson. Always here on CNC, of course.